Good afternoon, dear participants. This is Dr. N. Sandhya Rani, Associate Professor, Department of Physics from Vidyavadaka College of Engineering, Mysuru. Dear friends, we all know how important is both matter and radiation in our day-to-day life. In this regard, I welcome you all and our today's resource person, Professor T. Demappa, for this national level FDP-SDP on recent developments in material science and radiation technology. It's a pleasure to introduce our today's speaker, Professor T. Demappa. He has completed his MSc PhD in chemistry from University of Mysore. He has published 71 online research papers and presented papers in 123 conferences. 25 times he has been invited to various conferences as an invited speaker and also as a keynote addresser in various countries like South Korea, Singapore, Malaysia, Seoul, Dubai, etc. 5 students have successfully awarded PhD under his guidance. He has a wide research area experience in the fields of physical chemistry, polymer composites, hydrogels for drug delivery, preparation of edible polymer films for food packing, polymer nanocomposite films, etc. Professor Demappa is awarded with Rashtriya Shikshana Ratna Award from Economic Growth and Research, New Delhi. He is awarded with Dr. Abdul Kalam Lifetime Achievement National Award for its excellent research work. We are very happy to have you, sir, with us today. I hope we all will be benefited from your knowledge. Now over to Professor Demappa. Sir, please carry on.
Okay, madam. Madam, thank you very much for warm welcoming and nice introductory words. Thank you once again. First of all, I would thank the organizer of this webinar. I once again thank you all the organizers and the institute and funding agency, whatever. Okay, before we start the webinar, I would say good afternoon, all of you, the participants. My topic today, we shall discuss about polymer composites. Okay, before start the polymer composites, I just introduction two general aspects of polymer composites in general. Okay, then polymer composites, it includes introduction. Introduction contains definition, classifications, and applications. Okay, definition. Composites can be defined as materials that consist of two or more chemically and physically different phases separated by a distinct interface. Okay, the different systems are combined judiciously to achieve a system with more useful structural or functional properties unattainable by any of the constituent alone. Okay. Then composites, they are wonderful materials. They are becoming an essential part of today's material due to the advantages such as they are low weight, corrosion resistance. Not only corrosion resistance, they are resistant towards so many agencies such as water resistant, fire resistant, thermal resistant, chemical resistant, atmospheric resistant, moisture resistant, sound resistant, and microbial resistance such as bacteria, fungi, mites, whatever may be, so many resistant. And they have high fatigue strength and faster assembly. These composites are very faster assemble and disassemble, especially in constructing materials like bridges, buildings, airspace applications, automobiles. They can disassemble and assemble very easily, very fastly. Okay. Then polymer composites or any composite in general, a typical composite consists of minimum two phases. Very, very atypical. More than that also possible, but typical composite is the two phases. One is the matrix phase and another is the dispersed phase or reinforcing phase. You will know that what is dispersing phase and reinforcing phase. Example, you know that what is RCC. Okay, that concept, it gives you the detail, what is called the composite aspects or concept. Okay, matrix phase, it is a primary phase. Okay, it is a continuous character. Matrix is usually a more ductile and less brittle or hard. So it is easily what is called combined with what is called reinforcing phase or dispersed phase. It hollowed it too easily, and matrix a load with it. Okay, it combines with the reinforced, and it is usually more ductile and hardened towards the dispersed phase, and shares a world with it. If you applied any load, stress, energy, pressure, whatever you, it receives first matrix phase, the outer phase. Then it transfer your pressure, stress, load to what is called the dispersed phase or reinforced phase. So it withstand without damage. That means your energy, pressure, or stress is dissipate in this region. Okay. Whereas in dispersed phase, it is stronger than what is called matrix phase. So it is called the reinforcing phase. Okay, reinforcing phase. Then come to the classification of the composites. Okay, definition is over. Then come to the classification. Based on the what is called matrix. Okay, the composites can be classified as metal matrix composites. Here, the metal matrix composites means the matrix, the used compound, that is used component is the metal. So metal matrix composites. Example, gold. Okay, gold is a matrix. Copper is a reinforcing material. Then only processing. Otherwise, it cannot be processing. It cannot, you know, bear any. Madam, hello. Is slide show badwa? North India. ಈಗ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ನೋಡಿ. ಓಕೆ ಮೇಡಮ್. ಓಕೆ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಈಗ. Okay, thank you. Okay, classification of composites. Metal matrix composites. I already told you that metal matrix means matrix is a metal. Take an example, gold. Gold is a matrix. It is a ductile and less harder. Then copper is reinforcing with what is called the matrix, that is a gold. Then it can be processing, otherwise it cannot be processed. A pure gold itself, it cannot be processed. It cannot any, what is called processing of any shape or size like that. Okay, and I thought that you can understand what is metal matrix composite. Then ceramic matrix composites. Ceramic matrix composites, here the matrix is inorganic compounds. You know that what is inorganic matrix and polymer matrix composites. Here the polymer matrix composite, the matrix is either polymer or polymeric resin. Resin means low molecular weight or liquid polymers, low molecular liquid polymers, low molecular weight. So that is either polymer or resin is the matrix. This is based on the matrix classification, based on the matrix. Then come to the classification on the basis of reinforcing materials. Take an example, fibers are the reinforcing materials. Okay, on the basis of reinforcing material, take an example, particulate composites. Suppose you are reinforcing material is particulate, particle size. It may be in milli or micron, nano, like that. That is particulate composite. Suppose if it is fibrous composite, fiber reinforced or plastic composites, FRPs. The fiber may be short fiber or a long fiber, or it may be synthetic fiber or a natural fiber. That is called the fibrous composites. And the laminate composites. So laminate composite means sheet-like, layer-like reinforcing material. They're called laminate composites. Fibrous composite can be classified into, you know, natural fiber and synthetic fiber. They can be further divided into, biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Okay. Biodegradable can be subdivided into what is called a green composites. Okay, that is called a green composite. These can be further divided into hybrid and textile composites. Okay, hybrid composite means it comprises a combination of two reinforcing materials, more than two reinforcing materials. That's why it is called as a hybrid, composites. Whereas textile composites, it is, you know that in recent advances in polymer composite, they are fiber reinforced plastic composites. They are very, you know, useful and potential applications in automobile, automotive, airspace applications, helicopters, like that. That is a for piece in building constructions, okay, like that. They are used in almost every type of advanced engineering structure, engineering structure or engineering structure. With their use, say, is ranging from aircraft, helicopter, spacecraft through boats, ships, and offshore platforms, and automobiles, sports goods, or sport articles, chemical processing equipment, and civil infrastructures such as what's called bridges and buildings. Okay. Then recent work on 3D FRPs, three-dimensional fiber reinforced plastic composites, they include manufacturing 3D preforms like weaving, okay, braiding or embroidering, knitting and stitching. This comes under 3D FRPs category. And then another category is fabrication of FRPs by what is called consolidation by what is called liquid molding, liquid resin, or mixed the ingredients of composites and pour to the mold whatever shape you want and size, thickness, whatever may be. That is also one type of what's called this one. This becomes an, you know, textile composites. Natural fiber composites, they may be natural composites, glass, it is also natural fiber, it is in the fiber nature, and carbon, that is also natural fiber, and Kevlar aromatic nylon, that is Kevlar, and boron fibers, they're all, you know, natural fibers. They're being used as a reinforcing materials in fiber reinforced plastic composites, which have been widely accepted as materials for structural and non-structural applications also. However, these materials, that means glass, carbon, Kevlar, and boron fibers, and so many other mineral fibers are also available. They are very good structural and non-structural application materials, no doubt. They are widely used. However, these materials are resistant to biodegradation. They are not undergo degradation. They are totally non-biodegradable and can pose a serious environmental problems. That's why, so we prefer for natural fibers from plants, okay, such as cotton, jute, sisal, coir, coconut coir, bagasse, sugarcane, bagasse, or any agro waste such as paddy straw, paddy husk, ragi husk, ragi straw, whatever may be, any agro waste is also used for what is called natural fiber reinforced polymer composites. Pineapple leaves, okay, these are have a very high strength and they can be used for many load bearing applications. Okay, these fibers have a special advantage as compared to synthetic fiber. In case of these fibers are abundantly available and also they are renewable resource materials and are undergo completely biodegradable. Okay, but they are poor mechanical properties because they are hydrophilic in nature. They have highly moisture content materials, that's why. But all natural fibers are hydrophilic in nature and have high moisture content, which leads to poor interface between the matrix and reinforcement. That's why your polymer matrix, it is hydrophobic, it is hydrophilic, the interface cannot take place, what is called a highly bonding interface cannot be achieved. That's why you have to go for modification of natural fibers. So many methods are available for what is called a modification of natural fibers. Then we go for processing of polymer composites. Okay, this is just introduction to this one. Uses. They are extensively used as materials in making aircraft structures, electronic package to medical equipment, and space vehicle to home buildings. The predominant useful materials used in our day-to-day life are wood, ceramics, concrete, and so on. Surprisingly, the most important polymeric composites are found in nature, and these are known as natural composites. They are fibrous proteins, the muscle and collagen, that is also muscle fiber, and bone are the advanced polymeric natural reinforcing polymers. They function both as soft and hard connective tissue. Okay. Okay, epoxy. Come to the what is called our topic, polymer composites. Epoxy, polypropylene, short fibers, clay particle, hybrid composite. I told you now what is hybrid composite. We are talking about polymer hybrid composite. That means here that two reinforcing materials are used. Epoxy is the matrix, polypropylene is a fiber, short fiber, and clay is also a reinforcing agent. It is in particulate status. In this paper, the preparation of epoxy, polypropylene, short fibers, clay particles, that is ternary composite, a three component system. So it is a hybrid composites. We can study their mechanical properties, thermal and flame retardant properties. Here the mechanical properties is, it is a common studies, but thermal stability and flame retardant or fire retardant properties is very, very important criteria in this presentation. होते। इंट्रोडक्शन, among the polymeric composite fiber reinforced composites have become a key players in automotive and aerospace industry. They are prepared by reinforcing fibers, any fibers for that matter, into the polymer matrix. So need not necessary for a detailed introduction because I given the previous general composite topic. So then come to the addition of clay here to the polypropylene epoxy. It increases the mechanical properties and what is called thermal properties and flame retardant properties. Okay, composite polypropylene fibers and epoxy showed a improved thermal stability. The same paper was published by T. Niranjana Prabhu, my student, and myself in 2007. This is published a paper in 2014. The presence of two reinforcing phases in a composite can change properties based on the contribution of these two reinforcing materials because they are not behave the similar properties. They may be behave similarity or they may be oppositely or like that. That is the difference is called the hybrid effect, and this effect is also called what is called synergistic effect. Okay. Experimental. That means how we prepare the polymer composites. Here the materials, aerodite, that is epoxy of a grade MY740. And accelerator K112 and another that is an ordner of HY918. It is procured from Huntsman Private Limited, India, from Bangalore. Polypropylene fibers were obtained from Reliance Industry, India. Its specification is like this: average fiber length was 3 millimeter. And average diameter was 40 micrometer. And come to the what is called clay, that is organic modified clay, that is called Cloisite 30B. It was procured from Southern Clay Products, USA, as a gift sample. The average particle size as given by the supplier was 10 micrometer or 10 micron, with a density of 1.98 gram per cm cube. All the chemicals were used without any modification. Then preparation of composites or laminates. Composites of epoxy, this ternary mixture, was synthesized by initially, the clay, polypropylene short fiber were mixed with 100 PHR, parts per 100 resin of epoxy, and stirred for 30 minutes at 1350 rotations per minute at the speed using a conventional variable speed of a Tanko stirrer, okay, like that. Then 1 pH of accelerator, that is K11, and 85 pH of ordner was mixed with epoxy and polypropylene and clay mixture for another 5 minutes at the same speed. With the same speed, the contents were transferred to a Teflon mold of the size 200 millimeter into 100 millimeter into 300 millimeter. The samples were cured at 100 degree centigrade for 2 hours. And post-cured for 120 degree centigrade for 4 hours. Okay, then we characterization. Okay, characterization such as impact strength, that is isolated impact strength, ASTM D56 was conducted by UTM. was the what is called the instrument was procured from UK, and tensile testing was carried out by the same ASTM standard, ASTM D638, and the flexural testing was also carried out by ASTM standard, that is ASTM D790. Tensile testing was done with a stress range of 3000 megapascal, and strain is around 300%, and speed is 5 mm per minute, whereas flexural testing was performed in a 3-point configuration. Then thermal properties. Thermogravimetric analysis, TGA, was used to carry out the thermal resistant. The equipment is from Japan. The temperature range between 30 and 650 degrees centigrade. So we have to subject it to heat our prepared compound from 30 to 650 degrees centigrade. Then it undergoes degradation. Then the degradation kinetic study was carried out, both energy of activation, order of the reaction, what is the compound decomposes for 5% weight loss and the 10% weight loss, like that. These are the detailed kinetic study was also studied. Its heating rate was 10 degrees centigrade per minute in nitrogen atmosphere. The nitrogen flow rate was 60 ml per minute. To check the flame retardant properties, that is very, very important. Flame retardant properties are we concentrate here. This was checked by underwriters laboratory. 94 tests were conducted as per the procedure of underwriter laboratories USA. Okay. Then morphological study was also carried out by environmental scanning electron microscope, the Mekis Netherlands. Okay, it is very important, results and discussion. After preparation of composites and design the specimens that cut in by ASTM standard for tensile, flexural, impact, like that, Young's modulus, then we carry out the test. Okay. Here the results and discussion. First of all, we shall discuss about impact strength of these composites. We vary the epoxy, polypropylene, and clay composites versus impact strength. Here, the pure epoxy without adding any reinforcing agents, reinforcing materials like polypropylene fiber and the clay, only pure epoxy shows 83.5 joules per meter of what is called impact strength. Then we are adding 0.1 phr of polypropylene and 0.1 phr of clay. Then the mechanical strength is increases, that is impact strength, that is the 104.2. Similarly, it increases with increase of what is called hybrid composition. The maximum impact strength is found to be 162.7 with corresponding to 0.5 phr of polypropylene clay and polypropylene fiber and clay particle. Okay, this is the maximum impact strength is found to be 0.5 phr each. Afterwards, the mechanical property decreases, that impact strength is decreases. Okay, then tensile strength. Okay, tensile strength. Here, the pure epoxy is found to be 40.2 megapascal. Whereas, if you go on increasing the polypropylene and clay content, the mechanical property increases as that of what is called the previous case impact strength. The maximum tensile strength is found to be 50.6, correspond to 0.5 phr each of clay and polypropylene. Okay, we can note down that value. We will discuss in table 1, okay, 50.6 for ternary composites. Then afterwards, if you go on increasing the what is called hybrid composition, then it decreases. Okay, then Young's modulus. Young's modulus also behave the same properties as that of the previous two. The maximum Young's modulus is found to be 3058 for the 0.5 THR each. Please note down that value also. We will discuss in table 1. So the Young's modulus will also increase with respect to. Here the flexural strength also same. Note down. Then go to elongation break, elasticity, the flexibility of the material. Okay, here this is contradictory or vice versa to the previous cases. If you go on increasing the hybrid composition, the flexural strength or elongation break decreases because the addition of a clay, it reduces the plasticity of the composite. It reduces the what is called deformation of the plastic matrix, that is epoxy, and then it becomes a brittle. So it becomes what is called flexibility to what is called brittleness. So a pure epoxy is found to be 8.3% of elasticity or elongation break. That means it break, the compound is a break at 8.3% of stretching elongation. Pure. Then we are adding clay and polypropylene, then it requires less energy. That means brittleness increases. Even you can bend it, it can easily broken. That it is brittleness. Flexibility decreases because I told you the epoxy, that it is no doubt it increases mechanical properties in the previous case, but here it pull out the fibers. It leads to the what is called reduce the deformation or elastic deformation of the epoxy matrix, any matrix for that matter. It reduces its what is called elastic deformation. Okay, that's why it decreases. Whereas in the previous case, the mechanical property increases with the increases of what is called hybrid composition because there is uniform distribution of particles and clay particles and fiber particles. So the mechanical property increases. And also clay, it enhances the interfacial adhesion between the matrix and the face. So mechanical property increases. And then there is a much epoxy resin to wet, the sufficient wet of these two components, that is clay and polypropylene fibers. Then it properly curing takes place. That means if it is curing, means mechanical property enhances curing. Okay, then further increases, and also what is called, if it is further increases beyond 0.55, there is a less amount of what is called epoxy. It is not sufficient to wet, so improper curing takes place. So that is one of the factor to decrease the mechanical property. And also another factor is there is agglomeration takes place. There is no distribution of the particles. They are somewhere, they are accumulation, they are agglomerate, they are lumpy like structure. That's why they are not uniform distribution. And also the stress is concentrate on that area, then it leads to crack, micro crack will develop. Go on further addition or loading of these fibers and the clay, the micro cracks will develop macro cracks and collapse the structure. So the what is called mechanical property decreases in all the cases: impact strength, flexural strength, and tensile strength and Young's modulus. Okay, that is the reason why the mechanical property increases a certain extent. No doubt, clay will enhance the what is called mechanical property. I will show you table 1 and 2. You will understand easily by analyzing numerical values. and what is called mechanical property increases at an extent 0.5 PHR is the maximum. Afterwards, it decreases because this is what is called these are the factors. Then okay, table one, the mechanical properties of the comparison of the two composites, that is binary composite and the ternary composite. First one is that is without adding what is called clay, only epoxy 0.3 PHR and polypropylene also 0.5 PHR. Okay, that's then the impact strength is 170.3. Whereas ternary composite, in the previous case I told you, no, please remember that value, that is impact strength is found to be 162. So this is 162. That means the ternary composite have show the lesser mechanical properties than the binary composite. Similarly, all the properties you see, tensile strength, Young's modulus, flexural strength, elongation, break. Tensile strength 56.2 without clay, with clay 50.6. Young's modulus without 3202, whereas with clay 3058. Similarly, especially burning rate, this is very important. We are concentrate on this aspect or concept. Here the decreases. So clay, it is decreases thermal, you know, property, thermal stability, and flame retardant property enhances. Like that. That is the main criteria. Here, thermal properties, we cannot see the, you know, the plots or reinforcing. We'll discuss in table very in detail. So in this study, the TGI used for thermal properties, thermal stability and all, the rate is 10 degrees centigrade per minute. We calculate the degradation kinetics for all the samples by using Horowitz-Metzger equation. This is the equation. We calculate the degradation or reverse kinetic study. Formation of the product, that is one type of kinetic study. It is commonly all the research are going on. But this is the rare research, that is reverse kinetics. Okay, degradation kinetics is very rare. Okay, then come to Horowitz equation. Then these are the parameters to calculate the kinetics parameter. This is the plots for Horowitz Metzger kinetics plot. We plot a graph of ln ln 1 by 1 minus a versus theta. Then we plot a graph, all the you know, plots are straight line. The slope gives you the energy of activation, and intercept, it gives you what is called order of the reaction. So another equation for this that is Freeman and Carroll. This is another equation. We plot a graph by using this equation. Okay, Freeman and Carroll, that is log dw by dt to log of vr to get a 1 over t log wr. We'll find the same straight line, and the slope itself, it gives you energy of activation, that means thermal stability, and the order of the reaction. Okay, this is most important concept here, the flame retardant properties. These properties can be studied by underwriter laboratory 94 test. Here, the pure epoxy, that is the sample specimens for burning in the two methods. One is the horizontal burning and another one is vertical burning. All the horizontal burning were successful, whereas all the vertical burning tests were failure. So this material is used for what is called a construction material and agricultural and what is called decorative purpose. Okay, burning pure epoxy, it burns 7.3 millimeter per minute. Okay, without 10 clay. Clay is used for what is called flame retarding material or fire retarding material or thermal resistant, because it is insulating material. clay. That's why we use very cheap and it is easily affordable material. We not go for any halogenated compounds or so many other inorganic compounds. Halogenated, that means they are hazardous to health to eliminate chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine. That's why VOC, volatile organic compounds. They are also PVC and all, they are hazardous in nature. That's why we use it for a simple material, that is a clay. Okay, that is insulating material. And after 0.1 pHr of clay, it reduces to 4.6. That means that sample, we can burn only 4.6 millimeter per minute. Okay. Whereas without clay, it takes 7.3 millimeter. Further addition of 0.2 pHr, then it reduces to 4.2 millimeter. And 0.33, 3.9, 0.55, 3.4, 0.77, this is the maximum. Otherwise, beyond 0.7 pHr, that clay and fiber cannot be mixed. Okay, it cannot be mixed. That's why this is only restricted to 0.7 pHr only. Somebody asked why you can't go for beyond 7 like that. Because it is not mixed properly. This is the maximum 0.77. 0.1 pHr to 0.7 pHr is only capable. So here, this is why this is decreases means flaming, what is burning test. Clay, it consists of H2CO3. That means it contains water and carbon dioxide. Okay, when it is subjected to temperature 30 to 650 degrees centigrade, I told you now that is when it decomposes. Okay, and it degradation. When it decomposes, it eliminates what is called impermeable gases, low molecular gases. And usually, first it eliminates water and carbon dioxide first. So carbon dioxide is a self-fire extinguishing material. So it put off the fire, it cannot combustible. Okay. And also, when you subject it to temperature or burn, especially it's burning flame, when you subject it to flame, when it burns, it leave behind a char, a thin layer of a char material. Okay, thin layer of a char. Then there is avoid, it prevent the contact between fire and oxygen and your composite material. So fire cannot be burned. And another one property, clay is also what's the kind of layer material, layer by layer material, laminates. So it acts as a barrier for the what is called combustible gases and fire or oxygen also. So the oxygen will not interfere in the burning. So these are the properties of clay to reduce the what is called burning rate. So usually the literature value, the burning value is the limiting value is 75 millimeter per minute. But our values are very, very low, especially 7.3, not 4.6. That's why it is very, very useful material for flame retardant material. Not only that, that is also useful for, it increases a high mechanical property also. So one table, it was missing. I think okay, this one. Okay, sorry. Thermal properties affects how the clay increases the mechanical property. Because table one referred as without adding clay, the mechanical property increases. But you may ask, why? What is the need of clay for mechanical property? Definitely, mechanical property increases with the increase of what is called clay. Here you see the pure epoxy, that is, these are the values for degradation properties, 165, 0.11, 197, that is increases. that is 33, afterwards it is decreases. Okay. Okay, come to the morphological studies by environmental scanning electron microscopy. This is the picture for pure epoxy. This is, then it is 0.1 PHR. It indicates that, it shows that the clay particle and fiber particle uniformly distributed. Okay. Then for 0.2 PHR, this is the maximum for thermal stability. So here the epoxy and polypropylene fiber and clay particles are distributed, whereas 0.3, the agglomeration starts and the cracks are noticed. These are the cracks noticed. So further increases, that means loading of polypropylene fiber and clay, you see the agglomerate, some fibers are accumulate somewhere, that is agglomeration. They are not distribution uniformly. So it forms a weak zone. These are the weak zone. Okay. These are the weak zones. Okay. Like that. Then conclusion. That means this composite, the thermal stability increases, no doubt, with increasing of hybrid composition. And thermal stability and flame retardant properties are so good. Okay, this is the compound we use. Then this is what is called synthetic fiber reinforced plastic. Then we will move on to what is called, these are the references. I give you a very brief introduction to natural fiber reinforced plastic composites. Okay, same type of other publication from my student and myself, thermal degradation kinetics of, instead of polypropylene, we used HDPE, remaining is same. So this is another work. It is very, very, you know, low cost technique. Study of mechanical properties of sawdust, waste of sawdust, waste to wealth. Okay, even its properties are superior than your teak wood or neem wood, whatever may be. Its size is very 0.5 mm thickness. Any teak wood or any neem, it cannot withstand 0.5 mm thickness. You can bend it can easily be broken. And this material is resistant towards so many agencies, waterproof, acid proof, alkali proof, like that. And weight to strength ratio, that is aspect ratio, is very high. That is an engineering material. So introduction is not necessary because I given a lot of information in the previous cases. Preparation and characterization and application, I will just briefly go through this one. Okay, the major advantages is they can be easily disposed at the end of the life cycle. Okay, after life cycle, end of this duration, shelf life of your composite, that is a sawdust composites. It is, you know, not hazardous to health. It is easily degradation, and it is become a manure or compost, natural compost. And it is used for what is called calorific values, for fuel burning like that. Whereas in synthetic polymers, it cannot be like it. So that is one. And also they are highly biodegradation and performance and acoustic performance. This is very important. All natural fibers, they are light in weight. Okay, they are easily degradation, and acoustic performance, sound absorption. Okay, that is also very important, high mechanical strength and loss. Come to the materials. What are the materials we have used? epoxyresin horoldite LY556 and Horner HY9551. These are procured from Zenith Industry, Bangalore. And sawdust, it is collected from sawmill Mandya. It is cured only at a laboratory temperature, can also be or at any elevated temperature. Okay, that is one of the this one. And we are studied absorption studies, water absorption, NaOH absorption, acid and all. And 11 specimens were synthesized here. Just very briefly, not in detail. Okay, characterization, flexural properties, ASDM D790, the same studies, impact strength, flexural strength. Results and discussion. Just I do one or two tables. Represents mechanical properties of the composites. You can see this is epoxy, the tensile strength is 40, then 95% of epoxy and 5% of sawdust, then mechanical property increases. So 90% of epoxy, 10% of sawdust increases. If you reinforce the waste material, the property enhances and cost will also reduces. Okay, whereas epoxy is it requires some cost, but it's free of cost. So we can increase the sawdust and avail the same performance. So 85% of epoxy is hydrophobic in nature, and this is 44%. 44.4 MPa megapascal of tensile strength, not percent, it is a megapascal tensile strength. And maximum 80% of epoxy and 20% of sawdust, you will get a maximum tensile strength, that is 46.421 megapascal. Similarly, tensile strength also 991.82 approximately, or it's called 990. Similarly, flexural strength also increases. Impact strength also increases. Afterwards, it decreases because I told you, same what is called distribution. They are not properly wet, not in proper curing. And stress concentrate, micro cracks. These are the properties. And afterwards, I will mix. These are the poor mechanical properties. Then I want to make it enhanced by adding Horner here. Only 5% of Horner, then it increases. You see, 24, 25, this one, but it is higher than this one, 29%. Similarly, further increases. That means if the Horner increases, it is easier to distribution of what is called particles, reinforcement, and also wetting properly, and proper curing takes place, then mechanical property increases. Then water absorption. Water absorption means more water absorption, degradation takes place, poor mechanical properties, shelf life decreases. We have to tailor-made the properties. You can increase the water absorption if you want to, biodegradation, environmental friendly product, you can go for. Or you want to increase the shelf life by resistance, so many resistant, water resistant, waterproof, acid proof, sound proof, UV, thermal, fire. That can be tailor-made properties by reinforcing other additives, not too reinforcing material, more than that. Okay, fire retarding material, fire retarding fillers, surfactant, compatibilizer, because sawdust, it is a maximum mix up to 50% only. Onwards, it cannot be, distribution. Then you go for some plasticizers, compatibilizer. Then it is easily compatible, like that. That means, depending upon the tailor-made applications and customer specification and desired product, you can tailor-made the combination. Then change the structure, property changes, and property changes, applications also change. Like that here, you see 90% of epoxy is hydrophobic. So the water absorption, 6 hours, 12 hours, 18 hours, you can see 12 hours, 18 hours and 24 hours will stay. Then after 30 hours to 42 hours, the water absorption will remain same. Then 48 hours, little bit increases. Then similarly 80%, that means 20% of sawdust, 80% of epoxy, then hydrophilicity increases, hydrophobicity decreases, hydrophilicity increases because cellulose, sawdust, it is a abundant molecule of hydroxyl group is present, OH group. That's why it absorbs more water. And another one is the mechanical property decreases, means it cracks takes place. The micro cracks or macro cracks, then the water is penetrating into the, you know, what is called cracks, then water absorption increases. That is also possible. That's why you can make, if you want to, you know, biodegradable or non-biodegradable, that left to you. That is the case. If you go on increasing what is called this content, sawdust, then water absorption increases up to 13%. Then we go for hardener. This is hydrophobicity. Then it is decreases once again. 0.86, like that. Similarly, I'm not to go for this one. I straight away go to this is maximum 0.3 NaOH. NaOH is increases the mechanical properties certain extent, later decreases because it decomposes and degradation of some cellular compounds like any cellulose lignin. They are very strength to the fibers, so those compounds are dissolved in high concentration of NaOH. But the limited concentration of NaOH, the property increases because fats, wax, and non-cellulose materials will dissolve. Then pure cellulose, lignin, and other, so strength increases. Then we go for NaOH. It is increased because OH group abundantly present in both cellulose, OH, sawdust, and NaOH. Certainly, it increases. Whereas HCl also, it is a polar in nature. The more absorption takes place and degradation, more the shelf life decreases. That means your composite property will decreases with the acid because it undergoes hydrolysis. Esterification takes place because cellulose and this one. So it drastically decreases its mechanical property, delivery properties in acid. NaOH, some extent 0.5 NaOH up to 0.5 NaOH, the mechanical property enhances. Okay, afterwards it decreases. Okay, just I take 5 minutes. Okay, come to the just 5 minutes. Radiation effects on polymer compounds. Okay. Gamma radiation effects on structural, thermal, and electrical conductivity properties of silicon ammonium nitrate, doped with HMC-based biopolymer electrolyte fields. They're very good. Paper of polymer composite films is studied by, invented by Professor N. Sandhyarani, Jason Noppa, myself and my student. This paper was published in IOSR Journal of Applied Physics in 2014. It is a summary of this paper is, we can study the structural properties by XRD and electrical properties, okay, by using what is called the changes its structure by inorganic material CaN, that is HCl is a non-ionic compound, then we make it ionic backbone or matrix. Then it conducts electricity. And also in addition to that one, we have to expose it to gamma radiation. Then it decomposes, certain extent the properties enhance, mechanical property enhance, because it's curing, radiation curing, mechanical property increases, secondary crystallization takes place, and further entropy increases, because crystallinity to amorphous nature increases. So entropy enhance increases. So mobility of the ions easily under at higher temperature, the conductivity will also increases, and also in case of radiation dosage like 20, 60 and 100 kilogram. So ionically conducting polymers are important materials both for fundamental studies as well as practical applications in high energy density solid state batteries, super capacitors, fuel cells, smart windows, sensors and electrochemical devices, etc. This is also gamma radiation induced effect, HPMC, same by the Ken Sanjiaroni et al. It is also published in 2014. This is also Sanjiaroni work, CdCl2, CdCl2 cadmium chloride. It is also same work for, you know, microstructural studies, conductivity and energy effect, thermal stability, all the other properties. So I am thankful to Professor N. Sanjiaroni, because from her I published more than 9 papers, a very good papers of composite films. I say thank to N. Sanjiaroni, Professor N. Sanjiaroni. Then radiation. So wood can be preserved for many years together when exposed to radiation. Otherwise, wood can undergo deterioration in any agency, external agency, moisture absorption, insecticides, UV radiation. But when you expose it to radiation, especially gamma radiation, the what is called wood or wood materials or artifacts can be preserved for a, okay. And also the defects can be identified by what is called gamma radiation because they are highly penetrating. And some structural properties will also changes. Okay. This is gamma radiation by sterilization method, radiation necessary for wood sterilization. And finally, microwave radiation also used to irradiate the what is called natural compounds for wood especially. And then manufacture for printed circuit boards and integrated circuit boards can be synthesized and preserved for years together by exposure to radiation. And finally, I want to finish it up. Thank you.
I thank Dr. Demapati Demappa for a wonderful and a very informative session. Sir, there are few questions. Demappa sir, can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Sir, there are few questions, sir. Yes. I will just note. I have noted down those questions. You please kindly
okay,
answer.
Okay. Okay.
Sir, the first question is whether there has been a sugarcane fiber have been developed till now.
Yes, yes. Composites.
It's already. It's been developed, sir. Sugarcane fiber.
Yes, madam. Yes, we are also synthesized the bagasse, that is waste sugarcane bagasse from composite, and also what is called carboxymethyl cellulose. It is what is called promising material for sensors.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. And the second question is, what is the difference between polymers and conducting polymers?
Okay, madam. Polymers, they are the majorly insulating materials. Not only insulating means thermal insulating and electrical insulating both. But if you want to make it electrical conductance by changes to structure modification, structural changes by doping, complexing, or blending, grafting, these are the modification of a polymer backbone or polymer structure, then it conducts electricity. You are published more than 8-9 papers, no, that is by what is called extrinsic conducting polymers. Intrinsic conducting polymers mean conducting polymers. They are intrinsic conducting polymers. The structure, the original structure itself, it conducts electricity when it's subjected to electric field or voltage.
Sir, the last question is. Do this polymer composites have any practical applications in flyovers?
Oh yes, madam. So many applications. Sawdust particles, no? That is the superior than your teak wood and the neem wood, any wood. Its density is very less and high strength, and so many other resistant towards water resistance, acid resistant, alkali resistant, and high salt concentrations. Even it withstands for marine applications. Even metals cannot bear or withstand in sea water. No, it's a highly concentrated salt. It is highly fast corrosion takes place. But these materials, they are withstands any concentration of salt. Okay, and also lightweight and acoustical performance. It is used for theaters and auditoriums and false ceiling now for protection of heat and all. False ceiling, lightweight false ceiling. They are not a ceiling, but false ceiling, lightweight. They are prepared from ragi husk, paddy husk, waste, agro waste, banana fiber, like that.
Sir, all the questions raised by the viewers were wonderfully answered. I am very happy to tell you, sir, that we have viewers throughout India for today's session, and your presentation is binding on
one inspiring word to the students, especially. This polymer and polymer composite, it is very, very useful for especially your branch, engineering branch, because it is a fabrication, not on the paper. Okay, you feel the product, you fabricate the product, you can reduce the what is called solid waste, waste to wealth. You go for collect the plastics, you can reduce fibers, you can eliminate. You can both in original resin, you can go for any structural materials, and also what is called environmental friendly, and also it is what is called it is the funding agents will come forward to give any funds for this project. No need to wait for government jobs. Even you go for small scale industry. Okay, ma'am, thank you. This is my main aim, to say some few inspiring words to the students or researchers.
So tell on behalf of Department of Physics and all of us, I thank Professor Dhemappa for delivering a wonderful and a useful session on the polymer composites. I also thank our event coordinators, Professor Karthik R, Dr. Dilip CS, and our department HOD, Dr. Divakar. I thank all participants for attending today's session, and we look forward to meet you all again for a second day talk on nanomaterials, nanotechnology and their applications. So tomorrow again we have this session from 3 to 4. Kindly join us. Thank you all. Thanks a lot for a wonderful session. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your kind cooperation for participating in this lecture. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.